My name is Ben Levy. I'm a station manager in Greater Manchester Fire and Rescue Service. I've been a firefighter and an officer for 16 and a half years now, and I've worked at places including Bolton, Salford, Wigan, Stretford, and currently I'm at Fire Service Headquarters. I've been to many instances as an operational officer, some more memorable than others. One that springs to mind was early hours of the morning, a house fire in the Bolton area. We knew en route from messages from control that there were reports of two children trapped in the house. En route to the fire, as a person's reported fire, as we call it, we were getting ready in the back and we were considering who was going to do what, whether we were going to need a ladder and how we were going to get water. As we got into the street, I remember quite clearly thick smoke issuing out of the upstairs bedroom windows, and also it was coming down onto the road and sinking around the cars. I remember this because I remember the blue flashing lights of the fire appliance were reflecting back off the smoke. When we got there, we got off the back of the fire engine and ready to go in to the house. The front door was closed and my colleague, my breathing apparatus partner, opened the door with our door ram, and we managed to get in quite quickly and took a hose reel with us. There's four firefighters went into that front of that property that night. Two firefighters went into the back kitchen where there was a small fire, which had rapidly got hold, and they went to tackle the fire. And we went to the staircase to find the first floor. I can remember going up the up to the first couple of steps, and there was a small fire at the bottom of the stairs. I remember tackling a small fire before we went on. And I can remember at this point, the officer in charge at the front door shouting into us to remind us that there was two children inside, like we'd forgotten. I wasn't aware at the time, but what had happened outside at this point was the mother of one of these children had turned up at the house and was obviously screaming and very, very distressed outside. Couldn't see anything in front of our face at this point. It was very, very black, very, very dark. I can remember we had our breathing apparatus sets on and torch was on my shoulder here, and I could see the beam of the light through the very grey and very dark grey smoke. Just about see the steps, and as we walked up, felt our way at the steps on all fours. It was quite warm, and I could just about see the carpet on the stairs. When we got to the landing went left and right, and we got onto the landing. I was on, had my hands on the top landing step, and as I looked to the left, this is where I saw the young girl lying on the floor. I can picture to this day, really. She had a pink nightdress on. She was probably about 9 years old, and she had quite long hair. And her eyes were open. She wasn't moving. Quickly, I managed to get hold of her shoulder and pull her towards me. And I shouted to my breathing apparatus partner behind that I had a girl in my arms. At which point, thankfully, I'll never forget this, as I pulled her towards me, was the first point that I realised that this girl wasn't dead, because she moved and she made a sound which sort of got my heart racing even more to get this girl out quick. Anyway, between the two of us, we got back down the stairs, helped by another breathing apparatus crew that had joined us from our neighbouring fire station, and we got this girl to the living room and out to the front door. I recall at that point that en route to the fire, we were told that there were two children in the house, and this was just the first of the child. And as we handed over this child to the officer in charge who had waited at the door for us, I can remember to this day the scream of a woman outside. Now, I don't know if that was the mother of this child. I'm not sure to this day. It was a noise that will stay with me, really. We went back into the house to look for the second child, by which point another breathing apparatus team had got to the first floor. When we got to the first floor, as I said before, the landing went left and right, and there was a bedroom to the front of the house and a bedroom to the back of the house. We went to the back of the house, which as soon as we entered the bedroom, we realised it was a children's bedroom. And so we focused our search on this. And we found this second child underneath a duvet at the back of the bed. I'm not sure. My suspicion is this girl was trying to either hide from the fire or was trying to protect herself from the smoke, but this girl was under the duvet. And again, I can remember the fear of dread when we pulled the duvet back and picked up this girl. I thought at the time I was picking up a dead child. Again, luckily, thankfully, this girl, again, similar age, about 9 years old, shorter hair than the last. She moved slightly in my arms as I picked her up, and I turned around, I passed her over the bed to my colleague, and between us we carried this girl out. I led the way out, whilst protected the area for him, whilst he made his way down the stairs with her behind. We went out. We didn't go back into the property again. there was another team fighting the fire downstairs, another team completing the search, and soon a message was sent, which all persons accounted for, to say that we'd got all the children and everybody out of the house. The scream that I heard earlier in the evening when we brought the first child out continued while we were outside, and I found it very, very distressing and very, 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 very hurtful. It turned out, I found out later in the evening, that the two children we'd rescued from the house fire were home alone in that house. And there wasn't any militia start at the fire. I think between the two of them, they tried to make themselves some tea while they were alone on a sort of sleepover, and they'd had an accidental cooking fire. This was a number of years ago. I don't recall to this day whether there was any smoke detectors in the house. I can't remember any sounds like that. I can't remember any sort of preventative fire safety measure that was in place in that house to protect those children. But thankfully, those two girls came out. But I think another few moments, and I think, unfortunately, we would have had two very poorly young girls.